I say my mind on the secret master plan, the black and grill with the cash in my hand.
I got to have the world in my hands. I'm a god, I'm no longer a black man, the black god. I got to have the world in my hands.
Live art.
Oh, you tell her where you are? She gonna come and see me? Oh. I'll be friends with her.
The wall got torn down.
Yeah, they got put back up in a lot of ways. But
I was being funny.
One of the things that happened there was a year.
Really like the doctor.
Oh, it's like
a drummer. Or
they won't work. It hooks up to the phone, okay? And then the phone hooks up to Facebook.
Okay.
But I can't do anything with it. I can't even get on Facebook down here.
Right, neither can I.
I can't get on there.
Y'all hear Motor City Black Age.
So I didn't expect anything more or less.
Show started at 11.
Like, the rest of the story was shit, but like as far as like the way he looked,
he was the best functional guy.
Yeah, he looked cool.
And the little one-liners with him was hilarious.
No, that was the best part of the movie, man. Just with them.
Set it up now. Finish this. Mental man piece. CDs are, you know, shirts. Make it work hard on the piece. Almost done. Just add some more words. And some more drawings I had in the background. She can really sing. She's really dope. But I'll find out her name. It's around 2 o'clock now. People coming in and out. Women coming in. People trickling in and out.
Genetic inheritance. Alright, that's just something to think about.
That's why I studied this stuff, because when you learn it, it helps you to heal. It helps you to learn some things that you didn't really know. It helps you to see things from a different perspective, and it helps you to understand life in reality as well as life in fantasy or life in the spiritual. It helps you to understand life on various levels. So it's very important that we learn this kind of thing. Right? And that's why when they start talking about Black Girl Magic, I'm like really getting excited, like, oh my God, this kind of coming back. This energy is like, they can't stop it because it's time again. Okay?
Same thing Bobby Hammond was talking about earlier.
It's important because there's too many Black girls and women who believe that they cannot be powerful and that they are not beautiful. I was raised in a community where they told women, you ain't nothing without God. You ain't nothing without this. You ain't nothing. You ain't nothing. I've watched my mom, my aunts, cousins and them, lovers, constantly put themselves down, low self-esteem issues, not understanding how powerful they really are. That's why this kind of thing is important, because the Amazons taught women about their strengths and their weaknesses. So that's
very sparkly and very beautiful. That's my opinion. Hopefully it's yours.
I'm here at the Breakfast Club.
And I'm asking for $100 for that tonight, just because it sets the spirit for the holiday. How about that? Would anybody be interested? Okay. Let me know. Have a good night.
$100. And I had to pick. Okay. All right. Thank you so much.
All right. Thank you, Jack. We'll be maybe talking with you later. Maybe. Okay. All right. Michael Warner.
Again?
No, he was only representing the gallery. That was Matt's piece.
Hello everyone.
This is Michael
Horne.
Peace, everybody.
This is a mixed media, mostly acrylic, and a couple of pieces I collaged on there. Some of my original pieces I did. So this size is 36 by 24. Horner's Gallery. Yeah, Horner, Michael Horner's Gallery. Yeah. What else did I name? Horner's Corner? Yeah. And again, I always squeeze another piece. That's one of my pieces on the wall back there, the blue, and the piece of Horner Stone is up in the TV, up in the front.
How much is this piece?
That piece is really sold.
Oh, yeah.
It's gone. Yeah. And I just want to thank everyone for coming, and this is a beautiful set of people here. And I just keep on doing what you're doing. There's no competition with yourself. There's no competition with yourself. There's no competition with yourself.
All right, this is the piece I was working on that I've been showing y'all. I feel pretty good about it because, you know, it's the first piece I finished in a minute. You know, I've been drawing, but, you know, and I did the summer job where I was painting, but them not, it wasn't for me. I mean, it's not for me either, but, you know, it's for the buyer. But, you know, piece I made on my own time that I finished. I think I'm going to add something else, but I'm not sure. I think I'm going to call it transmutation, even though I already had a piece called that, but I had took some of the stuff off that piece because I'm basically redoing most of my collage pieces, all of them really. So I had redid this because first it was done with a hot glue gun, but after talking to another collage artist, I just started using this gloss gel as an adhesive too, and I got some Mod Podge. Yeah, I think, is this the one? Yeah, this called Transmutation. So I've had took this off the site. And I'm redoing this one. This called Madness. I had took this off the site. My shop. And it's gonna be back soon after I redo it. Make it look better. Do it with the adhesive stuff I got instead of hot glue. Cause with the hot glue, it tends to like kind of break off and whatnot. You know, I want my art to, I want it to last. And I ain't do these people. Cause I had got this piece of wood back in 12th grade from my friend, Miss Infamous. She actually rap. I should check her shit out. My damn nails hurt from peeling off all this damn hot glue that's still on the wood. But I've been burning it, as you can see. So, pretty much done taking this off. I'm going to try to see if I can get some of these off. And I'm going to redraw most of these because they got damaged when I was fucking peeling it off. So, yeah. Progress so far.
Well, you're not sniffing that shit again, are you?
I didn't smoke. I told you smoking gives you hangovers, not alcohol.
Jesus, man, I thought you quit that stuff.
I'm on my holidays.
Separated. Stuff that I redraw. Background stuff. Drawings, place on the foreground and whatnot. Snigger brand.
TV, but if you take a look here at the St. Clair Shores Police Department, you can see there's a memorial here for X. The man who created these t-shirts wants to change the dialogue.
I made these t-shirts to give a voice to the people.
This is the t-shirt gathering some attention. We can't show the shirt on TV. It has an obscene word on the shirt stating blank that dog.
I am not condoning any violent acts. I'm not condoning anything that goes against our personal rights as people in America to say how we feel.
Police say they were called to Lakeland Manor Banquet Hall on reports of a man with a gun last Sunday. That call led to an officer-involved shooting where both Axe the Canine Dog and 29-year-old Theo Gray were shot and killed.
The importance was placed on the life of a canine officer or a dog who does not share the same rights as a human being in this country.
Pictures of Turner outside the St. Clair Shores Police Department wearing the shirt is going viral on Facebook. While some people are asking how they can purchase one, others are upset. One person writing, "That's how you respect an animal that gave his life to protect people? Very sad." Another post simply says, "Disgusting."
I've gotten death threats. I've gotten racist comments.
We did reach out to the father of Theo Gray. We were told they did not know that the t-shirts were being made and did not authorize them to do so. Turner says he did not know Theo, but hopes the shirt will spark a conversation.
I'm not condoning no violence, only commentary and steps towards change.
There is a candlelight vigil being held for Theo Gray tomorrow. The Macomb County Sheriff's Office is still investigating this officer-involved shooting. Reporting live in St. Clair Shores, Allie Hoxie, 7 Action News.
All right, to be continued. Allie Hoxie, thank you for that live report. And we want you to take a good look at your...
My nigga Brandon.
...to find this man. He's accused of...
Hell, another copyright strike. I don't know if this shit... Got it, but I'ma just silence it anyway. Finally done, I believe, with this picture. But I'ma turned it in tomorrow to Blick. They having a winter artist showcase at Noel night. So I'm gonna drop that off tomorrow, or today, since it's like 3 a.m. or some shit. Just framed it. I mean, I framed it, but made it ready to hang. And, if it don't sell at Blick, then it's gonna go up on the shop. Feel good to make a piece that's for me, not for me, but you know what I mean. That's bigger than 9x12 and shit. And, you know, still finding new ways for my art like this, you know, to protect it. I was looking up like stuff with resin, maybe putting it over the art to, you know, have some type of protection for it. Since this on wood, I'm not really sure about a frame for it. I think that'll be possible though. But I'm gonna just keep on looking into ways, you know, to make this shit work for me. So, you know, it looks good and archival in people's homes and whatnot. That's one of the reasons why I redid it. Because if I just had to, put the hot glue gun, it wasn't gonna last long. But since I had the adhesive and the Mod Podge, you know, it's better.
Go.
All you gotta turn, like I said, I'm gonna drop this off at Blick. I'm about to drop it off within the next hour, really. Probably do a video, music video. Then when I get back, I'm gonna do some more work on this. Pretty much done with the background. Got like this left. Boom, You know. I got like a little color reference sheet. Got the energies of the colors I wanted to use. You know. Then I'm gonna start on the foreground. Redraw the pictures I had in the pile that I showed. Yeah. This is another one I was redoing. Called Madness. It's gonna have the same pictures, but you know, they're gonna be redrawn, and you know, songs added. So I'm pretty excited on what it's gonna look like. Taking my piece in a Blick. On my way to Midtown at Wayne State. New sketchbook. Shout out my grandma, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, on my way to Wayne State downtown, well, Midtown. There's this thing called Optimize Wayne. They're doing certain things where they can help you with your idea, and they're giving away $20,000. You know, I had an idea. It was like a service for artists. I don't really want to talk about it just because you know how shit be. Manifestations and people got your idea and the collective, you know. But anyway, yeah.
Exactly what the problem is and fully know like the causes of the problem, where the problem is located, who is being impacted by this problem, and how you are going to be able to solve that problem. So we are going to have a session on problem analysis right now that's going to be led by Sergio, and he is the founder of Todoly, and he is also the director of the Ask an Expert program and the leader of the Innovation Hub on Wayne State's campus, and he was part of our very first cohort 2 years ago. So he started his entrepreneurial journey with Optimize Wayne and has gone around to numerous accelerator programs in the city, and conferences around the nation to work up and build his idea to what it is today. So with that, just make sure that you remember that he's an incredible resource for you guys over the next few months that you're going to go through this challenge. And so with that, we welcome Sergio Rodriguez.
So don't let the stories fool you. I'm actually a pretty big deal. Thank you for having me here, Kavi and team, for Optimize. I really, really appreciate what you guys did for me a couple of years ago. I received my first $2,000 check, actually, from the Social Innovation Challenge. And that completely changed the direction of my life, at least today. I was originally planning to go to medical school, and I can't believe that now I have been delayed that for like almost 2 years to pursue a dream that I never thought I would be pursuing now. So I really wanted to talk to you guys about your ideas, because I know every single person here has an idea, which is great. I love ideas, but I do want to talk to you guys like Apple wanted to do that. Anyone have an idea why they do that?
Competitors.
What is it? Wait. I'm going to make that. They have competitors. They have people who might actually be able to execute on that idea, right? But it's not even just that. So a company like Apple actually employs over 20,000 people, and they are just recently got announced this year to be a $1 trillion company, which is pretty crazy, right? They're valued over $1 trillion. And for somebody like Apple, if Samsung goes to market 24 hours before they do, you're talking about millions of dollars in revenue, right? If someone in this room doesn't go to market, by a certain time, it's not going to make a difference. I promise you that. Nobody's going to be unemployed. You're not going to have to reduce dental benefits for anyone. So I just wanted to drive that across. So there is a difference, right, between people in this room having an idea and then like a big company like Apple or even Amazon, because those people are at the level where they're executing, right? Challenge. You need to understand what social innovation is. So a system. Camila, what is a system? Mm-hmm. Can someone give me an example of a system? What is it?
Can you raise our hand?
Mm-hmm. What is an example? Do you have an example?
Of like a system that's running?
Yeah, just any system.
The prison industry?
Yeah, the prison system.
Yeah.
It'll usually have the word system in it. The education system, right? There's a lot of systems out there in the world. What is it, like the health system, right? That's a pretty common one. So these systems are actually put in place by people like us. And what social innovation really is actually identifying the vulnerable populations that we leave behind in these systems. So the education system, right? It's an awesome system to have, right? It's all about optimizing how we can get people more educated so that in the long run we can do a lot of really good things. But so it turns out that there are many communities, even in the United States, who actually fall vulnerable to these systems because they're not perfect systems, right? These systems that are big systems, they sometimes miss people, and those people become vulnerable people. So what social innovation really is taking a look, like a macro look at those systems and trying to see where the holes are, right? Because what is the most important thing? Is it the idea? No, it's a problem, right? If you can take an outside look at those systems and you can look at it from bird's eye view down, you might be able to see those holes and you might actually find real problems that need to be solved. And where there are problems, there's opportunity. When there's opportunity, there's potentially money.
This guy, the driver, you're the driver. Maybe you have to have additional insurance for your tires. You have the credit, you have to apply for credit. So you see how complex it can be when you're doing an interview, and this is why you have to know who your customer is and everybody in the whole circle that works around them. Because you won't just be interviewing the end user. You have to interview everybody in that sphere. Okay, so how do you find interviews? How do you develop them? Well, lucky for you guys, you have social media that is able to get you connected with everyone within minutes. So you have to start developing these lists of how am I going to find people to interview? where do I start? So you can start in LinkedIn, Facebook. A variety of you have already a huge following. You may be influencers in the field. So leverage those networks to try to get that list of interviews in place for you. And then for those of you that are in a specific business or a specific industry or vertical market, you may go to that organization's. They have publications, maybe magazines, newsletters, something that's affiliated specifically for that industry. So how do you contact them? Generally, you want to have a strategy to make sure that you're not wasting people's time. You don't want to be another telemarketer, do you? No, you don't want to. So be very, very targeted. If you're starting, say for example, you have you want to start a business where you're going to be doing something, I don't know, transportation of goods or anything like that. Are you going to go to Amazon and want to talk to the CEO and say, I have this great idea? Probably not the best place to start. You want to start lower. Look at something that's more manageable. Be realistic of who you can contact. Maybe you just want to find out with a regional manager or something like that. Being able to use your network, find people that you know that can make your introduction for you, and then send an email. Kind of do a cold call. Those are hard to do. Anybody like to do cold calls? Oh yeah, we have one. Nice. Cold calls are hard to do, but I would advise you to play the student card. I'm a student at Wayne State University. Yeah, and everybody's like, yeah, I'll help you. Sure, I'll help you. Because the moment you graduate and you say, oh, I'm a graduate, I have a degree, and they're like, oh no. You have to pay for our service. You have to pay to talk to us. So. Remind them that you're there for insight. You want to hear what they have to say. What do you learn from your interviews? You're going to learn a lot, everything. You should learn everything from your interviews. It's hard. It's very, very hard. When we take the students through DTX, by week 5, they're exhausted because they're trying to do 10 to 15 interviews a day. It is very hard to pay attention. Isn't active listening a hard skill? Yes, you know, you have class, and you know, you have an instructor, and you're trying to pay attention. Well, you're gonna be doing the same thing when you're doing an interview. It's very hard to listen to people intently. And then you're taking notes, or someone's taking notes. So you wanna be sure that you understand what you're trying to get from them. Make sure that you're learning about their pains. That's the most important thing. What is their pain? And we talk about there's a shark bite and then there's a mosquito bite. Are people gonna pay top dollar for a mosquito bite? Unless it's malaria. But most of the time you really wanna know what that customer is having trouble with, because they're most likely gonna pay you to be able to alleviate that pain that they're having. Not necessarily that you can't make money with a mosquito bite, but it's kind of better if you know that they have a shark bite. And understand who has the decision to purchase or buy your product or service. You may be talking to somebody and they say, I would absolutely buy that. I would absolutely buy that. And then you find out they're not the decision maker. Maybe it's a husband that says, yeah, I'm going to do that. And then it's the wife that makes financial decisions, and he's not able to do that. So understand the decision-making process. And then who is going to support you and who's going to sabotage you? Who is going to sabotage you? Got to have some discernment as you move forward and have critical thinking to make sure that what you're getting from those interviews are going to help you. And it is fearful. It's uncomfortable, but you'll get through it. You will get through it. So this is you. This is your perception. I have the best product. It is so cute. It's gonna save the world. This is you. And this is what you give out to the world. And are they gonna tell you, you have the ugliest baby in the world? That is the dumbest idea. You are never gonna go anywhere. So don't fool yourself. Listen to these interviews. If people are constantly telling you, no, I don't have that problem. I'm not gonna buy that. Listen, don't fool yourself. Don't keep the ugly baby and think I have a pretty puppy and I'm gonna move forward. That's what customer discovery is all about. Discover what the customer wants. That make sense? But as you go through, you don't want to, you know, don't sell. And we're going to teach you how to do this. You don't sell your product. That's not the intent of customer discovery. I have this clicker, and I want to sell you my clicker, and I think that this clicker can do the best thing. I'm talking about my technology. I'm an expert in this field. I design clickers. I know how to use a clicker, so therefore it makes me an expert. And then you say, do you want a clicker? And what are people going to say? They're not going to tell you that you have an ugly clicker. They're going to tell you, oh yeah, sure, I'll do that. But realistically, people won't execute.
They don't really have to behave if you don't want to.
These are my pieces right here.
They are?
Yeah.
Wonderful.
I love it. I love it.
So,
yeah. Tell me a little bit about it.
This is a t-shirt I made, hand drawn on. Like things like this. These are like a series I did called affirmation stickers. And these are certain symbols on different stickers. That's a handmade wallet, or hand painted wallet. And I have like bookmarks for like my lyrics.
And what's your name?
Damon.
Very good work.
So, I should try it.
Have you just started doing art, or have you been doing it for a while?
Yeah, I've been doing it since I can remember, really.
Are your parents artists?
My dad, he draws, and like my grandma likes to color, and my granddad was an artist. Alright, they bought her. Santa. This is charcoal soap?
It is, yeah.
Cool. You accept credit card?
I do. I've got the square thing.
Okay, cool. What's these?
Those are Rose of Jericho. So they're really interesting. They're plants. And they look like they can live like this completely dead for like years. And then you put it in a shallow dish with distilled water, and within an hour it starts to unfurl and come back to life. They're really amazing. And they, like, the water you use for like spell work and different things like that, but it's really just a really cool plant. And then you can go back and forth with it. Like, you can let it live for a while and then take it out of the water and it'll go back to this state, but it'll keep like growing back to life. They call it like a miracle plant because it doesn't make any sense how it can sit like dead for years and then just come back to life with a little bit of water. So
like, what kind of spells could you do with the water?
Well, it's just, since it's kind of like a resurrection, like a, you know, it's a good for like a change or like good
like a road luck, opener or something like
yeah,
that.
Yeah, road okay. opener, like Albert Camino stuff is really good for that. Yeah, so okay. the water's real good. It's like, and I always use distilled water just because tap water has all the
yeah, all that.
Crap in it. Yeah. So,
no.
Yeah, it's a really, it's fun to watch. It's just a really cool thing to have. So.
Cool. This?
No, it's a straight photograph.
Oh wow!
Photoshopping them.
Damn.
Same with these.
Wow. That's dope. You got a car?
Yeah.
Yeah, my name Damon. I'm an artist too. I got some art in the next one. For sure. Illustration, custom clothes too. Places in Detroit?
They're all Detroit, yep. They're all Detroit. Lighthouse is a little farther out, obviously. But yeah, all the city walls are.
Where is the lighthouse?
That one is West Manning, so it's kind of like how we do with our hands. It's like up here.
The little random part of Michigan?
Yeah. Yep, this is Point Mestee.
Wow.
And then this is Westing, I believe.
Thank you. How you doing? Good. What made you choose Acorn?
I think that stones and trees were really nicely together. But I've always just kind of collected them.
That's dope. That's a nice like theme you got going.
Thank
how you doing?
Hey, sticker if you want, or you got a card there.
This yours? Did you draw like a little girl on a balloon?
Uh-huh.
Getting hung by a balloon?
That one?
Oh, no.
I had a couple of them with that little girl on the balloon.
Are these all acrylic?
Yeah. Sometimes I put a little oil in them, but I like working with acrylics.
Dope.
It's a lot more useful.
How long they take you? Yeah, I'm a vendor. I'm in the next room.
Oh, cool. I haven't even had a chance to like look around.
Yeah, it's so much. Trust nothing else, even though sometimes I don't even trust the heart, you know? Gotta trust yourself, though, huh? Thank you. copyright strike. Swagger, swagger, Jesus Christ, my swagger, Jesus Christ, my swagger, Jesus Christ, I'm Christo, I'm swagger, swagger. Okay, I'm not used to this phone. I just got this shit. My last one kept not charging. Man, but anyway. It's the 30th. Sold these pants off the shop. But since it's Friday and the post office is closed. Oh, that's a fly. Gnat, whatever. But since it's Friday and the post office is closed, I'm gonna ship it on Monday, which will be in the December vlog. What? Yeah, I'll get a better look at it in the December vlog. But yeah, man, more content coming soon. More different content, throwback clips, compilations, reviews, making beat videos, you know, whatever. Music videos.
Kinanza.
Yeah, nigga.
been waiting to fucking rap over a beat by this nigga.
Bullets coming on my ladder to your top. Took your shit while you was off that straight drop. Piss yourself while you was begging me to stop. I wonder how much can I get from that.